Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
My God, my God.
Mm-hmm.
My God, my God.
Amen.
The Bible lets us know that we have to be ye also ready. Now, when Pastor started talking, I thought Pastor was just joking. Because I didn't come here prepared tonight to preach. Because it was not
on this schedule.
It was not on the agenda.
That's
But I heard a sermon last Monday night that where the preacher told us that we don't need to worry about our own agenda. We need to seek God's agenda. So it might have not, it probably wasn't on my agenda tonight, but evidently it was on God's agenda.
Amen.
And God said, be ye also ready. So I didn't choose myself. I didn't call myself. God called me to this thing. So I believe deep down in my heart, who God has called, God has equipped.
Amen.
So, and I mean, I was thinking, I thought Pastor was really joking. And I was sitting here and I said, well, and the first thing I opened, when I opened up the Bible, I said, as the Spirit of the Lord, I said, well, God, you called me. I didn't call myself. So be serious. I can't say, no, I'm not, because I believe God will make the way. So when I opened the Bible, it opened and it fell on James. James chapter 1. So here I am. James chapter 1. And it's so fitting from what was already said earlier in our testimony. James chapter 1, beginning at the first verse. And I'll be reading from the King James Version of the Scripture. And it says, James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes, which all scattered abroad, my brother, count it all joy when you fall into darkness. Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. But let patience have our perfect work, that he may be perfect all the time, wanting nothing. Let us pray. Most gracious and everlasting thou art, God. Father, I come right now, need no strength of my own. But I come, God, leaning and depending on you. I come thanking and praising you, God, for being God all by yourself. I thank and I praise you for loving us so that you gave your only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in you should not perish, but have everlasting life. I thank you, Jesus, for the blood you shed for us. Thank you for your Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, I say you welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, I ask right now that you come and you breathe a fresh anointing upon us now. From the crown of our heads, oh God, to the sole of our feet. Have your way right now, Holy Spirit. Move with me out of the way. Nobody can stay here from with me. But God, I'm asking you to send a word. Send a word from on high, Lord God. That God, you will be glorified and your people will be edified. God, I'm asking you to speak to me now, God. Speak to me, God, so that I can speak a word to you. Father God, and I'll do it all in the name of Jesus. I thank you for it right now. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Count it all joy. Count it all joy. The writer of this text, James, the book lets us know that he's a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. He begins to let us know, he begins talking in this text, letting us know that he says to us, he calls us brothers. You know, sometimes we go around walking with our head hung down. We go around complaining and murmuring about everything that comes our way. We go around blaming the devil for everything that happens to us.
Mm.
We go around looking for the worst in others. We go around just being, if you will, ungrateful.
Yes.
But, and we when we go to the doctor and we hear a bad report, the first thing we do, we begin to worry. We begin to say, oh, Lord, what am I going to do? Oh, Lord, the doctor doesn't see this. The doctor doesn't see that. When we go on our jobs and they offer us a pay slip, we start crying about how much bills we got, how much money we don't have. My house no do, my car no do, my this, that do, my everything do. When our children begin to act up, we start saying they're this just like this somebody and they're just like that somebody and they're never going to be this and they're never going to be that. When marriages begin to have a little test. We run to the next person, we run to this one, and we run to that one. We even run to somebody else. We run to signing divorce papers. When our children begin to act out in school, we run, we go fuss with everybody, all the principals, administrators, everybody. When our bank accounts does not, the dollar amount does not equal up what we think we should have or what we think we should need, we complain. But the writer is telling, let us know tonight that when we fall into devil's temptation, we should count all joy. Not some of it, but all joy. When we walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, even when we're going through that period in our lives, the writer is still letting us know that we should count it all joy. Knowing this, that the trial of our faith, it brings about patience.
That's right.
As I sat and I listened to the testimony, And all of them are so familiar with all the things that we've all in our lives experienced. But one thing I found out, that when I learned to trust in Jesus, when I began to say, listen, I know that you have not brought me this far to leave me. When I begin to fall, to realize that these situations are too big for me.
Yeah.
I read in this word where it says, if I trust in the Lord with all my heart.
That's it.
And lean not to my own understanding.
Yeah. That's it.
But in all my way.
Go ahead.
Not some of my ways, but in all my ways, acknowledge him and he'll direct my path. So when I read this word and I I let what folks say bother me.
That's right.
I let what I figured I couldn't do bother me.
Amen.
I let what I thought was going on in my body bothered me. I let what was going on in my finance bothered me. I let what was going on in my family bothered me. When I took my life to Christ. See, sometimes we try to put the cart before the horse.
Amen. Mm-hmm. All right. Now. Yes, yes. All right.
We want the quick fixes in our life.
Mm-hmm.
But then we don't want to surrender all to God.
Amen.
We want God to run to us currently when we fly over here and this is not right. When we go over here and this is not right, we, oh God, come, God, come, God, come. But we don't want to surrender ourselves totally to God, where that He can build us up to be the person that He has called us to be. Believe it or not, church, God, when God made each one of us, He made each one of us knowing exactly what we were able to handle and what we could.
Yeah.
I found out, church, that we got to trust Him and never doubt Him. I found out, church, that when I just lean on Him, no matter what the doctor's report says,
mm-hmm.
no matter what my finances look like,
that's right.
No matter what man says about me,
yes.
When I found out that when I learned what the Word of God
that's
says
it.
About me,
that's it.
I learned when I found out what God's Word said concerning my healing. I learned what God's Word said concerning my needs, I found out that it no longer becomes my problem. When I surrender all and I put it all in the master's hands, it becomes God's problem.
That's it.
He said, if we just live by His command, God said, if we just follow His commands, He didn't say if we had to, like Catholics say, dot every I and cross every T. He said, if you just love the Lord thy God,
that's it,
with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. He said that was the first and greatest command. And then love your neighbor as you love yourself.